Hi my dear students, or hello my dear friends, welcome to our agriculture extension subject. I am Dr. Lankati Mahesh, Department of Agriculture Extension. In this video I would like to explain what is meant by education, its definition, what are the different types of education like formal, informal, non-formal. So today we are going to explain step wise what is education meaning. Next, informal and non-formal education. Difference between formal and non-formal education. So today in this video we are going to discuss what is meaning of education, informal and non-formal educations, and difference between the formal and non-formal education. So what is mean by education? Here education is the process of bringing desirable changes to the behavior of human being. Here you can observe bringing desirable changes. Please, here in any examination point of view, please remember what is meant by education. Means it is the process. It is the process of bringing desirable changes to whom? The behavior of human being. The behavior of human being, that is called education. Okay, is it clear? Then we can see another definition of education. Education is the process of developing capability of individual so that they can adequately respond to their situation. Here, education is the process of developing, what does it mean? Process of developing capability of individual so that they can adequately respond to their situation. So education is the process of developing capability of the individuals so that they can adequately respond to their situation. That is the another one definition for the education. Then next one is, education is the process of teaching to develop the knowledge, skills or characters of the students. It is the process of teaching to develop the knowledge, attitude, skills or characters of the students. That is called education. For example, if you are joining a UG course, so as a teacher, as a lecturer, we can educate, we can teach what is the your UG program degree. If for example, if you are joining a BSc AG program or BSc commerce program, so what it is mean? So we are going to develop your knowledge, skills in that program. So automatically you are educated in that program, in that subject. So here you desire, what you should complete BSc AG program or BSc commerce, whatever it may be. Maybe so for that, bringing desirable changes, so this is called education. According to Webster, these are the different definitions given by the different authors. Then next one is, what is mean by formal education? Formal education refers to the hierarchically structured education system. please remember, what is that? Hierarchicalist structure education system means there are so many levels, from associate dean, assistant professors, associate professors, professors, and vice chancellors, dean. If you take school system, headmasters and class teachers, likewise. So formal education refers to the hierarchically structured education system running from kindergarten through the university, including Institute of Technical and Professional Education Systems. So here, from UG means you are kindergarten, from childhood through university, whatever you learn, that is comes under the formal education. So it is the, it refers to the hierarchically structured education system running from kindergarten through the university, including Institute of Technical and Professional Education System, that is called formal education system. Okay, next one, as we discussed earlier, informal education. What is that? Informal education system. So here you can observe, informal education is lifelong process. What does it mean? It is a lifelong process in which portions assume knowledge, skills, attitude, and insight from daily experience. Please remember, my dear friends, here informal education is a lifelong process in which you can assume knowledge, skills, attitudes, insight from daily experiences and exposure to the endorsement at home also. You can learn from home, you can learn from your friends, you can learn from your environment. So these are all are called as a informal education. Whatever you are learning in your life, that all comes together in form informal education. Here you can observe, informal education is a incidental and spontaneous. It is a incidental. There is no curriculum, there is no any schedule, no timetable. It is an incidental and spontaneous. Whatever comes to you in your life, you can learn from those situations, those events, and not pre-planned also. For example, if you are playing with your friends, from that play you can learn, not pre-planned and not imparted by any specialized age. In any age you can learn, not in child age, not in adulthood, not in young age, not in old age. In any age you can learn, that is informal education. No prescribed timetable or curriculum, just now I told. And maybe negative also, yes. From your neighbors, from your situations, you can learn negative things also. So this is called informal education. Here, now, non-formal education, that is, please remember, our extension education is a non-formal education. Why? Because now we can see, it is a organized and systematic education activity carried out outside the framework of the formal system. Please remember. So it is also organized and systematic education activity carried on where? Outside the framework of the formal system to provide selected type of learning to the particular group of population. It is organized system of education system or activity, no doubt at all. But where we are organizing, where we are educating the people outside the framework of the formal system to provide selected type of learning to the particular group of population, for children or for youth, for family members, or farmers, or entrepreneurs, whatever it may be, to whom exactly you are going to educate. You are selecting, you are giving education, you are teaching to them, then they are going to learn. Where outside the framework of the formal system, that is called non-formal education. Is it clear? So next we are going to see what are the different characteristics of the formal, non-formal education. Here, derive from the expression of formal education. Derive from the expressions of formal education system only. Okay, formal system means, yes, there is attendance is necessary. The student should be, between the four walls of the education system. So we derived from formal education system, but there is no curriculum. We are giving the education to the needy people. Then next one is outside the real interest of the formal education. Here, interest of the formal education, outside the real interest of the formal education. In definition itself we seen, we are educating the people outside the framework of the formal system of education, because the farmers can't come to the education institution. We should go as an extension agent. We should arrange the teaching situation to the farmers or entrepreneurs. So we are outside the real interest of the formal education and conscious and deliberate. What we are educating to the people, that should know by us, and intentionally we are educating them, because where they are lacking, where they are behind the education, where they are lacking knowledge, technologies, then we are consciously, deliberately giving to and educating them, and to be organized for homogeneous group. And means all are same age groups and same mentality, same needs. So those groups we are going to educate, serving the needy of the identified group. So this is also important one, serving the needy of the identified group. Who has need necessary, then only we are going to educate them. That is called non-formal education. Then we have to see what is the difference between formal and non-formal education. Please, my dear friends, most of the examination point of view, please remember what I am going to stress. It is most important one. Okay, here see formal education and non-formal education. Education concerned with the growth of the children and youth. Here, growth of the children and youth means in formal education system, so to improve their desirable behavior, what they have to complete UG, they have to complete a secondary school, intermediate, then degree, to achieve their goals, means their growth of the children's and youth. Here, in case of non-formal education, adults and youth actually life situation, means what they want in real life. whether they are going to entrepreneurs, they are going to agripreneurs, whether they want educate, they want education about the employment generation or training. We are going to educate in those situations, real life situations. That is called non-formal education. In case of formal education, attendance is compulsory. If you are joining a UG, there is a 75% necessary. In school days also, 75-80% is necessary. Based on the attendance also, we are going to assess the students in formal education system. But in case of non-formal education system, participation is voluntary, because if some farmers or some youth or some families are facing any issue, based on their needs and interest, they will participate. That is a voluntary. We are not going to force, come and say it, we are going to educate, we are going to teach to you. Not like that in case of non-formal education. It is a participation is a voluntary. Whether they have need and interest, automatically they will participate in any education program, any awareness program, any training program. So non-formal education, in non-formal education, participation is voluntary, please remember. And learners are relatively more homogeneous. This is also, please. In case of formal education system, learners are relatively more homogeneous. Please remember that word. This word, please remember. Means their education, okay? Their age, their knowledge level, and their courses all are similar. That's why the learners are relatively more homogeneous. In case of non-formal education system, relatively more heterogeneous. Means here, you can observe, if you are going to conduct any training program, any awareness program to the farmers, there are different farmers comes, different age group farmers may participate. And their age level, education level, their knowledge level are different from each and everyone. So that's why in non-formal education system, learners are relatively more heterogeneous. And fourth one, you can, in case of formal education system, you can see learners do not generally have any preconceived ideas, hence teaching is easy. Because in case of formal education system, in school, college and any universities, the teacher knows everything. Not knows everything means, but teacher's age is more comparative to the students. Means they can listen towards the teacher. And there is no preconceived idea, because teacher has to prepare first time and then explain to students. So it is easy to teach the students. But nowadays, okay, students also, earlier only they are browsing from internet, each and everything, it is another case. But in formal education system, generally, it is easy to teach the students in case of formal education system. But in case of non-formal education system, it is a preconceived ideas notion, because of their past experience teaching is challenging. It is very challenging task to teach the farmers or youth, because the as a extension agent, as a teacher of a extension, we can't predict or we can't explain what their experience they has. So they have already experienced persons, because of that they have some preconceived notions. So it is very challenging task. So for that we should prepare more. And here in case of formal education, curriculum is fixed. And in case of non-formal education, no fixed curriculum. Whenever it possible, we can conduct the education programs. But in case of formal education, curriculum fixed, because within a UG program is within 4 years you should complete. Okay, and teaching is more formal in case of formal education system, and in case of non-formal education is more informal, because there is no curriculum, no any coding, any means fixed curriculum is not there, and participation is also voluntary. There is no always informal in nature, means the farmers can learn very easily. And mode of instruction is vertical from teacher to students. Means here, as a teacher, he can convey his message directly to the students. Students may not have expressed their views to the teacher. But in case of non-formal education, horizontal shared learning between the learners. Means farmers also has their experience, they can share to the extension education teacher, and the teacher also can share their views to the farmers. Method of learning start with theory in case of formal education. Here, but start with the practical and goes on to the theories. It is time-bound program in case of formal education system, but it is participatory in nature. This is about the formal, informal, non-formal education, and what is the difference between the formal, informal, non-formal, mainly difference between formal and non-formal. I think most of you understood this lecture. Okay, even though if you have not understood, please comment on this video. I can explain in deep in our next video. Okay, so thank you for watching this video, my dear friends. For that, please do subscribe my channel. Please do subscribe to my channel and comment on this, whatever you have doubts, and if you like and share my videos. This is Dr. Lankati Mahesh. Okay, thank you for watching my video.